Hi students, in this video we will see how to construct a calibration curve by using a MS Microsoft Excel within a 10 minutes. Graph paper need not to be required, okay? Internet also not required. See, first you go onto your desktop, give a right click and press a new. So there you open a MS Excel sheet. There you find, you write it, file name, paracetamol calibration curve. Okay, now you open it. So I have a data here. After opening of this, concentration and x-axis. Don't write here concentration. Absorbance, don't write here. Okay, just keep first concentration values, that is 2 micrograms per ml, 4 micrograms per ml, 6 micrograms per ml, 8 micrograms, 10 micrograms. That data, x-axis, we are using that data. Concentration data, we are writing on the x-axis. So I will type here what I have: 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Okay, what is this concentration? Micrograms per ml. I will tell you where you have to write that names and all. Here only the values you can put. Next is absorbance. How much I got absorbance? I have to check now to everything on the UV spectra. I have to check now. After checking that, I have noted the values. Okay, I got here 0.3, next 0.4 I got, next 0.5, next 0.6, 0.7 I got. Now what I have to do is, you select this. This is the absorbance, this is the concentration. Now you select everything like this with your mouse or cursor. Insert scatter plot. Okay. See here. Now I got this plot for these values. See x-axis, y-axis, everything. Now what I have to do is just click on this horizontal lines. Okay. And you delete it. Need not to required. Now, take a left click, add a trend line. Add a trend line. So one pop-up will be open. In that pop-up, you select the linear, okay? And at the bottom, the three important, set intercept to a zero, that you made it, no problem, compulsory, you can made it. Display equation on chart and display R square value on the chart. Now you close it. See here, I got a curve now, calibration curve. So generally what we are doing is, we are going to be linking that, but you take a intercept as a zero, no problem, nothing will happen. Nothing will happen. Slope will not be changed. Okay, because everything is there, no problem. Need not to be worried. You will get a correct x-axis and where. Now, click on this, you bring here, okay? Now, and open the layout, go for layout. In the layout, you give a chart title, not x-axis title, y-axis title, chart itself, total chart itself, you can be make it. See how you, which model you want, which style, like this, above the chart we will place. So here, paracetamol calibration curve. Okay, at lambda max, which lambda max? Suppose say 250. So at 250, nanometer, you can type nanometer. If you want, you can elaborate this this one also, no problem at all, or keep it like that, no problem. Or you can reduce the size also. Home, you can reduce the size so that it fits exactly to that. Now, you want x-axis, no? Layout. Click on the chart. This is important. Click on the chart and go for layout here. And axis title. Here you will put x-axis. Primary horizontal axis. Horizontal axis is always x. So x, you want none. You don't want to write means you don't want. Title below the axis. See here I got. Now what is this is? Paracetamol concentration. Paracetamol concentration in which solvent? In water means water. You write it. You mention it. There nanometer also you can mention it. If you mention it is valid graph. Now microliters per ml. Microliters, micrograms per ml. Micrograms means here micro symbol. You have to go for symbol. In the symbol, you select the mu, insert, close. So micro came. Micrograms per ml. Now it is okay. If you want change the color, you can change the color also. And now I will click on this and layout, axis title. Primary vertical axis, that is y-axis, vertical axis. So how you want here vertical axis, you can do. So there what it is, absorbance, okay? And this series need not be, you delete it, no problem. You can delete it. And now, see here, this you want wherever you want, you can be shifted. See here, you can increase the size, decrease the size. If you want to change the color, no, go to the home, select first this one and go to home, give a red color. Okay, like that. You can do it very nicely. So now I got this curve. Okay, now what I do, this I will copy. This chart, entire chart, now I copied and I will paste in my thesis book. So suppose here I will open one new Microsoft Word, there paracetamol calibration curve. So here I opened a MS Word. See here, paste. So like this you will. Here also if you want you can change the color, whatever it may be. Okay. And at the top, need not to be write paracetamol calibration curve because already you have mentioned. There the thesis book, whatever you want, the thesis, the so and so we have taken, it comes in the quantitative analysis, not qualitative analysis. Qualitative means scanning. Quantitative means calibration curve. These two are very important thing. By seeing the graph itself, you can tell either it is a quantitative analysis or qualitative analysis. So you can save it and you can close the thing. Like the thesis books, you can be prepared. Okay, right. Now I will close this. So I will end here. Okay. So you practice twice or thrice. So you will get. Okay. End. Thank you. Thank you.